friends. I am Hameedhul Arshadh. First of all, let me introduce my team members.
I am Nikesh from Francis Xavier Engineering College, ECE Department, 3rd year.
Hi, I am Vignesh from Francis Xavier Engineering College, ECE Department, 3rd year.
Hi, I am Suresh from Francis Xavier Engineering College, 3rd year, ECE.
Hi, I am Vijay from Francis Xavier Engineering College, 3rd year, ECE.
So, let me get into the problem statement first. So like we are seeing a lot of news in the newspaper, like a boat sinks near the Tuticorin coast and six fishermen lives is in grave danger, and you know they are in the open sea for more than 12 hours, and so many news is like these kind of so many news we are seeing in the newspaper. For that, you know, we have taken this as a problem statement and we are trying to provide a solution for this thing. Then the main problem is fishermen don't have any proper communication device, you know, which could tell the information about the fishermen to some authorities that could really help the situation. So if a system is there for these kind of fishermen that could send their GPS coordinates and where they are and what the situation is, so then we could handle the situation far better than what we are actually doing now. So this is where our project slots in. The title of our project is an integrated smart alert system for fishermen's safety using IoT. So there comes a huge problem, because in the middle of an ocean you can't expect a good internet connection, for that matter even internet connection. So we have been thinking about this problem over a period of time, so we have came up with an idea that to use long range RF communication as a communication protocol, and using single portal device that could connect to the internet and send the data to the cloud, so that it can, the data can be viewed from anywhere. So from here on, our team member Suresh will take on the presentation. He will explain the components.
Now I'm gonna show you what are the components involved in this project.
LoRa module, this is act as communication protocol for our device through which the data can be sent between the devices. Next, ATmega 328P. It is a 16-bit microcontroller that is powerful enough for the processing that we require. Then GPS module. To get real-time and GPS coordinate, we are using GPS module. GPS coordinates consist of both latitudinal and longitudinal data of these devices. Next, accelerometer and gyro sensor. This is used to measure the acceleration of boat and lean angles of the boat. It is also capable of measuring the temperature. Next, 6-volt power supply with rechargeable. Next, 2-inch LCD display, which is used to display the data to the end user. Next, if the fisherman might be in a sea for than a week, so we need to supply the charge, the battery, so that our device remains active throughout the journey. For that, we go for solar panel, which is 10 volt. Next is ESP8266 module. Here we need to push the data to the cloud. For that, we have to access the internet. This is done through the device act as gateway to the internet. Then Things Speak Cloud. It is the open source cloud platform. The data from the device will push to this cloud throughout the gateway. Finally, we use Atmel for the software purpose for this project. Remaining part of this project will explain by my teammate Vijay.
I am Vijay. Now I am going to give you a brief explanation of our project that we are developing. We have developed a long-range high-tech communication device by which fishermen can stay connected up to 100 kilometers without internet or tower connectivity. The gadget, which will be fitted to the boat, will use GPS to log the location of the boats and periodically update the location to nearby boats. Besides, the fishermen will also receive information of neighborhood fishermen and also ocean weather forecasts. If a low-pressure area forms in the Bay of Bengal and is likely to intensify into a cyclonic storm, fishermen will be alerted in advance to take preventive measures. It also broadcasts the location of the neighboring fishermen in case of emergency, so they can help each other. The block diagram of the proposed system is given in the figure. Here, we are using the GPS module to extract the latitude and the longitude value of the location of the fishermen. Then, through the TTL module, we will give the data to the microcontroller. In our case, it is 80 mega 328T. Then the accelerometer and the gyroscope sensor data are measured and given as input to the microcontroller. Based on the sensor data, microcontroller will analyze for any kind of catastrophic events. In the case of a catastrophe, it is detected and then it will be sent an alarm signal along with the GPS coordinates to the fishermen. Normally, the accelerometer, gyroscope and the GPS coordinate will be passed as a single string through a long-range communication LORA mesh network to nearby devices. This data will be pushed to a cloud with a device that acts as a portal to the internet, which will be placed near the seashore.
From here onwards, my teammate Nikesh will explain the flow of operations.
Thanks.
I'm Nikesh. Now I'm going to explain how the LoRa mesh really actually works. Each device will have its own identity on the network. This ID is embedded right into the AEP ROM. Each device sends its routing information to the all the devices in the network. This is done through the concept called broadcasting. That's the one device to many device transmission. Each device will be given with an encryption key. Only the devices with its encryption key considered to be the authorized device. In the case a new authorized device wants to report in the network, it can be automatically configured with the network. This mechanism will prevent the unauthorized devices to connect to the network. Due to this, data is safe and secure.
The information is gathered by analyzing the sensor data, such as stability of boat and exact location of the boat. Then the information is processed as a single string for transmission. It is also encrypted to make sure that can't be accessed by others. The encrypted data is broadcasted over a LoRa mesh network. Finally, the execution takes place. In that, based on the received data, the controller indicates emergency situations to the end user.
From here, our team member Vignesh will be giving a brief demo of project how we developed so far.
Hey, this is Vignesh. Now I am going to give the demo on the project, an integrated smart alert system for fisherman safety using IoT, which we have developed. Now the transmitter module are going to connect the required sensor and LoRa transmission module. And the LoRa transmission module, it can be transmit up to 10 to 12 kilometers. And in the open sea environment, it can be transmit more than prescribed range.
Receiver. The visual which you are seeing in the receiver is scan for the emergency alert from the other fisherman port. On the event of pressing an emergency button in the transmitter sends all its data including the GPS coordinate to the receiver. The receiver identifies the alert by scanning and it's represented by white dot which you are seeing on the display. The receiver keep on scanning for the next alert. The visual what you are seeing is when an alert is received from the transmitter with the help of the coordinates received from the transmitters, the receiver starts its navigation to the fisherman boat in danger.
Now we are about to integrate all the components in a single PCB. Thank you.
To conclude, so let me come to the problem statement once again. The problem statement is that fishermen don't have a particular device that could send their coordinates to the authorities when they are in danger. So as we have mentioned in our demo video, we have developed a transmitter that takes the GPS coordinates, acceleration, as well as the lean angles of the boat. Based on that, the microcontroller calculates whether the fishermen are in danger or not. If they are in danger, then it will transmit the data of the fishermen in the mesh network. So the mesh network will be automatically formed, and all the data about that boat which is in danger will be transmitted to all the devices in the mesh network. So it will automatically find which node provides the shortest path to the internet portal, and from the internet portal it will update the data to the cloud. From the cloud, the authorities can view the data. So they can take preventive measures or any kind of activities to rescue the fishermen. So finally, I thank college management and i3indya for providing us with this wonderful opportunity. Thank you.